Celebrations of Global Tiger Day 2020 to be observed on 29 July kicked off. Union Environment Minister Prakash Javaikar releases detailed report of the 4th All India Tiger Estimation 2018 and poster on small wildcats of India. Bharatiya Janata Party National President J.P. Nadda inaugurates 8 newly constructed party district offices in Jharkhand. Says Prime Minister Modi took right decisions since the beginning of corona pandemic and gave the slogan, Jaan hai to Jahan hai, to interact with chief ministers of BJP-ruled states tomorrow. World Hepatitis Day being observed today. Lok Sabha Speaker, Union Health Minister, Union Law Minister and several other ministers attend the virtual empathy conclave. The theme for this year is Hepatitis Free Future. Total COVID-19 recovery cases in India crossed 9.5 lakh as over 30,000 recoveries recorded for the fifth successive day. Case fatality rate continues to improve and is further down at 2.25%. Global cases crossed 16.6 million mark with over 6.55 lakh fatalities. And former Malaysian Prime Minister Najib Razak found guilty of all 7 charges in the first of several multi-million dollar corruption trials. Najib pleaded not guilty to the charges of criminal breach of trust, money laundering and abuse of power. Hello, you're watching DD News and I'm Preeti presenting the bulletin. In the next half an hour, we'll get to an account of everything that's been making it to the headlines. Our top story first. Union Environment Minister Prakash Javaikar today said that India is ready to take a leadership role and work with other Tiger Range countries for the management of the reserves. Kick-starting the celebrations of the Global Tiger Day 2020 on the eve of International Tiger Day, the minister said that India is proud of its achievements and despite the scarcity of land and rainfall, it boasts of 8% of the world's biodiversity. Minister of State for Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Babul Supriyo, was also present on the occasion.
Leading from the front, India met its global commitment of recovering its wild tiger population and achieved the target set at St. Petersburg Summit in Russia 4 years ago before the timeline of 2022. India's tiger population now stands at 2,967, which is 70% of the global tiger population. A feather in India's cap was added with the Guinness World Records recognizing the country's efforts as the world's largest camera trap survey of wildlife. On the eve of International Tiger Day, Union Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Prakash Javaikar, dedicated this achievement to the people of India and frontline forest staff on the eve of Global Tiger Day 2020, which is on 29th July. During the event, Union Minister also released the detailed report of the 4th All India Tiger Estimation. He also said, this is India's soft power, which we must portray.
Duniya ke 70% baagh Bharat mein hai. Bharat ko garv hona chahiye. 70% हमारे पास है और 70% बाघों के साथ आज हम दुनिया का नेतृत्व करते हैं देखो भारत की ये सॉफ्ट पावर्स है और सॉफ्ट पावर को हमें दुनिया के सामने बहुत तरीके से ले जाना भी चाहिए
The Tiger Co-operators and Prey in India that book it is a detailed report of the 4th All India Tiger Estimation And it's very, very unique in certain ways. Number A, it has the abundance index of co-predators and other species that has been carried out, which was hitherto only restricted to occupancy. The sex ratio of tigers, the anthropogenic effects on tiger population, it has been elaborated in a detailed manner, which you can see in the book. The tiger abundance within pockets in tiger reserves, It has also been demonstrated for the first time.
Highlighting the keystone nature of the tiger, a poster on presence of small wild cats was also released. With the presence of nearly 30% of India's tigers outside of tiger reserves, India had embarked upon assessing management interventions through the globally developed Conservation Assured Tiger Standards Framework, which will now be extended to all 50 tiger reserves across the country.
Prakriti ka ek anmol ratna hai baagh. Aur jab baagh hota hai, to jangal achha hona padta hai, ghas hona padta hai, pani hona padta hai. और प्रे बेस जो है जिन प्राणियों को वो शिकार करके खाता है वो भी सब चेन होनी चाहिए. तो एक तरह से हमारे प्रकृति का ठीक होने का ये एक सर्टिफिकेट है.
Use of technology has been the new innovation for Tiger Survey that used M-Stripe's mobile application across 491 forest divisions. The information generated by this exercise serves to provide valuable inputs to guide policy and management. Tapos Bhattacharya's report for DD News, Delhi.
BJP President JP Nadda today inaugurated 8 newly constructed BJP district offices of Jharkhand through video conferencing. The 8 districts are Giridhi, Ramgarh, Lohardaga, Simdega, Palamu, Saraikela, Kharsawan, Dhanbad, and PS Singhbhum.
जिसने अपने आप को काम में लगाया और झारखंड भी इसमें पीछे है. COVID-19 का संक्रमण
Addressing the event, Nadda said that as far as BJP is concerned, it is evident that the party has remained active even during lockdown. He said that Prime Minister Modi took right decisions since the beginning of corona pandemic and gave the slogan, Jaan hai to jahan hai. Nadda also asserted that countries with great health infrastructure have collapsed, reason being they could not choose between humanity and economy.
लेकिन वह राशन भी ठीक से डिस्ट्रीब्यूट नहीं हो रहा है, उसमें भी घोटाले हो रहे. मित्रों, यह फर्क पड़ता है सुशासन का और कुशासन का.
स्पीकिंग फर्दर अबाउट द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ कोविड-19 पेंडेमिक इन झारखंड, जेपी नड्डा टारगेटेड द झारखंड गवर्नमेंट, सेइंग दैट द राशन सेंट फॉर पुअर बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी इज नॉट बीइंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन झारखंड प्रॉपरली. Targeting the state's government, he said that this happens when the governance is weak.
कल मैं सभी प्रदेशों के बीजेपी के मुख्यमंत्रियों से वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस में बात करने वाला हूं. लगभग 5,000 करोड़ रुपए स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स के लिए रखा है और इस 5,000 करोड़ रुपए स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स में 50 लाख स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स को जो हमारे सड़क पर जो ठेला लगाते हैं उनको सुविधा देने का काम किया गया है.
Nadda also informed that he will interact with chief ministers of BJP ruled states tomorrow. World Hepatitis Day is being observed today, and on the occasion, parliamentarians today participated in the second empathy conclave through video conferencing. The central theme of the conclave, organized by the Institute of Liver and Biliary Sciences, was Keep Your Liver Safe in COVID Times. Chairing the event, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla stressed on creating more awareness about hepatitis B and C, its prevention, diagnosis and treatment. He added that timely vaccination is the key to fight the disease. Om Birla, besides 235 parliamentarians who connected through around 660 web links, took oath towards working towards eradicating hepatitis.
तरीके से देश के अंदर हेपेटाइटिस बी और सी को रोक पाए और इसके लिए व्यापक प्रयास भी किए गए थे, क्योंकि पिछली बार एक अनुभव किया गया था कि पहले इसकी पहचान की जाए और पहचान करने के बाद इसके रोकथाम के इंतजाम किया जाए. कि WHO ने भी ये अभियान चलाया है और अन्य संस्थाओं के साथ साथ यू ने भी कहा है कि 2030 तक हम इस बीमारी को समाप्त करने के लक्ष्य को पूरा करें.
On the occasion, Union Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan said that it is the government's priority to ensure prevention and control of hepatitis in the country. He added that it is being ensured that benefits of the related government schemes reach the ground level.
भारत सरकार ने भी हम जानते हैं कि इसके हेपेटाइटिस के प्रिवेंशन के लिए, कंट्रोल के लिए इसको अपनी प्राथमिकताओं में रखा है और सारे देश में नेशनल हेल्थ मिशन के थ्रू इसके प्रिवेंशन के लिए नीचे तक, नीचे के स्तर तक इसके लिए सब प्रकार की जो सुविधाएं हैं उसको उपलब्ध कराने के लिए प्रयास हो रहे हैं। जो देश में 1.5 लाख हेल्थ एंड वेलनेस सेंटर्स बनाए जा रहे हैं वहां पर भी प्रिवेंशन के ऊपर बहुत बड़ा फोकस है।
World Hepatitis Day aims at enhancing awareness of the viral hepatitis and inflammation of the liver that causes a range of health problems, including liver cancer. The theme this year is Hepatitis Free Future. We get you more in this report.
Hepatitis Day is observed every year on 28th of July. The aim is to bring the world together to raise awareness of the global burden of viral hepatitis and to influence real change. The theme for this year's World Hepatitis Day is Find the Missing Millions.
Today we will be celebrating World Hepatitis Day. Hepatitis A and E usually do not cause chronic illness. They cause an acute self-limiting disease which is usually characterized by a mild viral prodrome followed by jaundice which recovers usually within the time period of 4 to 6 weeks. Hepatitis B and C can cause chronic illness and hepatitis and they both can cause cirrhosis of liver and later hepatocellular carcinoma.
There are mainly 5 types of hepatitis viruses. Hepatitis A and E are typically caused by ingestion of contaminated food or water. Hepatitis B, C and D are transmitted through contact with the blood or other body fluids of the infected person. Person infected with hepatitis may have jaundice, dark urine, extreme fatigue, nausea, vomiting, and abdominal pain.
A vaccine is available for hepatitis A and B, so that can cause safeguard you from getting hepatitis A and B. For hepatitis C, there is no vaccine at present available, and the precautions you can take is you can avoid getting blood from a person who are contaminated with hepatitis B and C, avoiding sexual intercourse with person infecting, and all pregnant women should get tested for hepatitis B and C.
Awareness about hepatitis and taking precautions may help to prevent the transmission of hepatitis infection. So on this World Hepatitis Day, let's take action to raise awareness of the importance of knowing your hepatitis status and spread the word about hepatitis. Kiran Bhardwaj, DD News.
Let's get to the COVID update in the country now. When we took off the total COVID-19 recovery cases, the cases have crossed 9 lakh as over 30,000 recoveries were recorded for the 5th successive day. And 35,175 patients were discharged yesterday and the recovery rate stands at 64.24%. The country's COVID-19 fatality rate has been progressively falling and currently it stands at 2.25%, which is among the lowest in the world. The government has attributed this dip to factors like aggressive testing and also an effective containment strategy. Added to this, India creates and maintains a new high of more than 5 lakh COVID-19 tests conducted in a single day over 2 consecutive days. According to the ICMR, that is Indian Council of Medical Research, the total number of samples tested so far is 1,73,34,885, including 5,28,083 samples tested yesterday. And up next, we'll take a look at the worst affected states from COVID-19 in the country. In Maharashtra, 8,706 patients were discharged yesterday with the recovery rate currently standing at 57.84%. 7,924 new cases were reported, while 227 COVID-19 deaths were reported in the state in the past 24 hours. The case fatality rate in the state stands at 3.62%. In Tamil Nadu, a record 6,993 persons tested positive for COVID-19 yesterday. 77 deaths were reported, while 5,723 patients were discharged in the past 24 hours. The total number of cases in Tamil Nadu so far stands at 2,20,760. In Delhi, the recovery rate stands at 88.68%. The national capital recorded 613 new cases of the infection, while 26 patients died in the past 24 hours. 1,497 patients recovered in the last 24 hours. Uttar Pradesh Deputy Chief Minister Keshav Prasad Maurya is on a visit to Ayodhya today. The minister offered prayers at Hanuman Gari and Ram Lala. He will also hold a review meeting regarding the preparations ahead of Prime Minister's visit. On the 5th of August, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be arriving in Ayodhya to attend the Bhumi Pujan ceremony for construction of the Ram Temple.
Hanuman Ji Maharaj, Bhagwan Sri Ram Lala Ji ka darshan karne ke baad, Sri Ram Janbhumi Tirth Kshetra, jo trust hai uske पूज्य अध्यक्ष पूज्य महाराज जी नृत्यपाल दास जी महाराज के श्री चरणों में प्रणाम किया हूँ। रामलला की जन्मभूमि पर भव्य मंदिर का निर्माण होने जा रहा है और भूमि पूजन का कार्यक्रम 5 अगस्त को है।
Meanwhile, the General Secretary of Sri Ram Janmabhoomi Tirth Kshetra, Champat Rai, has issued a video urging Ram devotees not to send gold and silver bricks. In his video message, he said that for the construction of Sri Ram Temple, at present, Ram devotees can send money which is needed, but has advised people not to send bricks of gold or silver. Meanwhile, Vishwa Hindu Parishad members left for Ayodhya from Badrinath Dham this morning by taking the soil of Badrinath Dham and water from Alaknanda River to worship Lord Ram in Ayodhya. Rawal, the chief priest of Badrinath Dham, Ishwari Prasad Nambudri and Dham Dharm Adhikari Bhuvan Chandra Unyal have proceeded with the water and soil this morning. In view of COVID-19 pandemic, Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan today held a cabinet meeting through a video link. The cabinet members joined the meeting from their respective homes. Addressing the meeting, the Chief Minister said that this is the first time in Madhya Pradesh when a cabinet meeting was held through video conferencing. He added that this is the proof of the government's commitment to continue working towards welfare of the people despite adverse circumstances. Shivraj Singh Chauhan was admitted to the hospital after he was diagnosed positive from coronavirus on Sunday, rather that was Saturday. Before this, Kerala held a cabinet meeting via video conferencing. And in Kerala, gold smuggling case, additional Chief Judicial Magistrate Economic Offences Court in Kochi today sent two accused, Swapna Suresh and Sandeep Nair, to a 5-day custody of customs in Kochi till August 1st. The court has also issued non-bailable warrants against accused Faisal Farid and Rabin K. Hamid on the request of Commissionerate of Customs Preventive. Both accused are currently in the UAE. The court also dismissed the bail petitions of 5 accused, Hamjad Ali, Samju, Mohammed Anwar, Jipsal and Mohammed Abdul Shamim. Earlier this morning, the NIA resumed interrogation of former Principal Secretary to the Kerala Chief Minister, M. Sivasankar, at his Kochi office. Yesterday, the NIA interrogated him for nearly 9.5 hours. He is being interrogated for his alleged links with Swapna Suresh and other accused in the diplomatic baggage gold smuggling case. On Friday, Sivasankar was grilled by customs authorities for about 5 hours in Thiruvananthapuram. And Pakistan violated ceasefire in Deghwar and Kasba sectors in Poonch district of Jammu and Kashmir today. At about 10 a.m., Pakistan initiated unprovoked ceasefire violation by firing with small arms and shelling with mortars. Indian Army is retaliating befittingly. The government has taken yet another step against Chinese apps, citing cyber security threats. Yesterday, 47 more Chinese apps were banned. Now, these apps are apparently clones or lighter versions of the already banned 59 applications. The earlier banned applications included TikTok and ShareIt Lite. Also, the government has banned a total of 106 mobile apps so far, saying they are prejudicial to the sovereignty, integrity and defense of the country. The action has been taken considering violation of privacy of the users and that of data security rules. There are indications that more such apps are being identified and action will be initiated as necessary. And flood fury continues in 11 districts of Bihar, affecting over 24 lakh people. Sitamarhi, Darbhanga, East Champaran and Muzaffarpur are worst affected districts. 17 teams of NDRF and 8 teams of SDRF are engaged in the rescue and relief work. According to the State Disaster Management Department, the Air Force helicopters made 11 sorties to drop food packets in Gopalganj, Darbhanga and Motihari. So far, over 1,67,000 people have been evacuated from the inundated areas. The government has confirmed 8 deaths in flood-related incidents. Cuts and protection work of 3 breached embankments are going on in full swing. Trains running on Samastipur, Darbhanga and Muzaffarpur, Natkatiyaganj are being diverted via alternative routes due to flooding of a rail bridge. The Met Office has predicted heavy to very heavy rains in the catchment areas of Nepal and Bihar for today, while there would be light to moderate showers in the next 2 days. And slight improvement in the Assam flood situation scenario could be seen in the last 24 hours, as the number of affected people have come down by over 2 lakh. However, flood-induced death toll has reached 103, with one more death reported from Golaghat district yesterday. 2,026 villages in 22 districts, along with 1,09,236 hectares of cropland, is still submerged. Gwalpara, Barpeta and Morigaon are the worst affected districts. Water level of rivers in at least 7 districts are yet to go down the danger mark. Besides this, 259 relief camps across the state are still sheltering over 45,000 people. In West Bengal, several areas in Siliguri have been waterlogged and normal life came to a halt due to heavy downpour in the past 24 hours. The only lifeline of the city, Mahananda River, is also flowing above the danger level. Now, according to the Irrigation and Waterways Department, Siliguri has received 75.6 millimeters of rainfall in the past 24 hours. And Union Minister for Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, Ramvilas Paswan, launched the Bureau of Indian Standards mobile app, that is BizCare, and 3 portals, that is Standardization, Conformity Assessment and Training portals of eBiz on the website. The mobile app BizCare can be operated on any Android phone, and this app is operational in Hindi and English and can be downloaded free from Google Play Store. The consumers can check the authenticity of the ISI marked and hallmarked products and lodge complaints using this app. The minister said that the government has taken several steps to protect the interests of the consumers. He also said that an important aspect of BIS functioning is certification and surveillance to enforce the implementation of the standards. And let's now take a look at the updates on COVID-19 situation from across the world. So far, more than 6.56 lakh people have died globally, while the total tally of coronavirus cases has reached more than 1.66 crore in the world. The situation remains worse in the US, followed by Brazil in terms of both infections and fatalities. About 44.33 lakh cases have been registered in the US so far, with death toll reaching past 1.5 lakh. Brazil trails behind US, recording 24.43 lakh infections, with death toll crossing 87,000. In some other international news, a Malaysian court today pronounced former Prime Minister Najib Razak guilty in his first corruption trial over the multi-billion dollar looting of one MDB investment fund. The current trial involved a charge of abuse of power, 3 charges of criminal breach of trust and 3 money laundering charges. He had pleaded not guilty to the charges of criminal breach of trust, money laundering and abuse of power. Najib faces a total of 42 charges in 5 separate graft trials linked to the case. And Najib set up one MDB shortly after becoming Prime Minister in 2009 to ostensibly accelerate Malaysia's economic development. Over $700 million from the fund allegedly landed in Najib's bank account. Najib's wife and several officials from his party and previous government have also been charged with graft. And up next, news just coming in. Supreme Court today refused the petition seeking direction to replace two members of the three-member commission probing Vikas Dubey encounter. The petitioner has sought replacement of retired DG K.L. Gupta and retired Judge Justice Shashikant Agrawal. And we will keep you updated on the story in the following bulletins. As of now, that's it in this edition of the news this hour. Thanks for watching. Namaskar.